Hi there. Welcome to this video. Today's Reiki meditation session is going to be about surrendering into trusting the process, which I know can be quite difficult for a lot of us. If you're ready, let's begin with the incense to commence the session. So the scent of the incense I have is a Balinese flower called jepun, and I got this last year. I totally forgot about it. So we're going to explore the scent today. Allow your eyes to soften as you watch the smoke, and just take in this moment, this present moment. Allow everything else to fall away. All that matters is that you are here now, in this space, receiving light. You're here because you want to surrender into trusting the process. Just take a deep breath in and exhale. Begin to relax. 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 Ground yourself into this moment. Feel your body. Feel your toes, your fingers. Feel the soles of your feet. Palms of your hands become hyper aware of the sensations in your body, and that will help you ground yourself in this moment. You can drop the shoulders and release the jaw. Relax the face. Now I'm going to draw the Reiki symbols so that we can invoke the Reiki energy. And you can just simply observe movement of the smoke as I do this. Okay. I have to say, the scent of this incense really takes me back to those Balinese spas that I used to go to. It feels like I'm back in Bali. It's really nice. Now that you are beginning to relax in your body, the Reiki energy is beginning to flow into the space, into you. Allow yourself to begin to release mind level chatter. Allow it to release and flow out of you. To help us with this, I have my trusty selenite wands. So this is going to help you clear away any murkiness from your aura. It's also going to help you clear away excessive thoughts. Thoughts of the past. Thoughts of the future. So you can be in this moment as you receive this light. Forget about the day. Because day has passed. So do yourself a favor and let it go. There's nothing else that needs to be done now. Release yesterday as well. release the past week, month, or even year if you have to. Let it all go. It has happened. There's nothing you can do now. Now release the future as well. So letting go of worries, anxieties, of future planning, see that you are actually very secure in this moment. So sit in that security. There is no need to worry in this very moment. You're safe. You're protected. You are supported. You are secure. Allow this resting awareness to flow to the heart now. Concentrate all your energy to the heart. I'm going to place my palms over your heart. Allow this space to warm up with Reiki energy, with light. Unconditional love and compassion. Rest your awareness in the heart. I'm asking you to do this because trust is a quality of the heart. The mind likes to resist, but the heart trusts openly, naturally, and comfortably. So rest your awareness here and give attention to your natural ability to trust. Your mind may question, well, what are you really trusting in? You're trusting in who you really are. Trusting in universal consciousness, which your inner being is always connected to. That really is your intuition. You are trusting in the natural course of things. You have to trust in the universal laws, in just the way things work. Because at the end of the day, things do work out. There always is a resolution. Surrender and trust that things can work out for you. Things are going to work out for you. Things will work out for you. Everything is working out for you. Breathe into that knowing which sits in the base of your heart. And let go of any resistance. Your mind wants you to believe that it has everything under control, that it knows what to do, how to do it. But the truth is, the mind is limited, and sometimes it's ignorant of its limitedness. In those moments, you really have to release the need to cling to the mind, release that resistance, and listen to your innate wisdom, which comes from your inner being, to help us with that. Have Angelite is very good for releasing emotional resistance, but also mental resistance. It's great for anger as well. And if you just observe it, observe the color and also the shape of this crystal, how it's round and smooth. Allow the visuals to inspire you into feeling a certain softness within yourself as well. Connect to the quality of this angel light and release your resistance. When you release the need to cling and resist and control, the path shows itself. Things will open up for you. So soften your mind, soften your body. And this can mean literally physically softening any tension you may have. Great places to observe are the jaws, shoulders, and I would say legs as well. Soften yourself into surrendering, trusting, and non-resisting. Let the angel light continue to work its magic. The selenite is here. The angel light is here. Allow all of that energy to just ruminate in this space and assist you. Now I'm going to shuffle my oracle deck. To see if it has any messages for us in terms of surrendering and trusting the process. What do we need to know? The card that we got is called the Fool's Tax, and the Fool's wisdom is live and learn. I'd actually like some clarification on this card, so I'm going to read the interpretation from the book that it came with. There are times in life when we make costly but inevitable mistakes. We depend on untrusty people. We follow the wrong road. We invest our time and energy in things that don't pay off. And we get hurt or humbled, lose money, sacrifice our pride, waste time, or even negatively affect our own health. Looking back at these wrong turns and missteps, you may wonder, how could I have been so stupid? How could I have allowed this to happen to me? It's so evident what went wrong when you examine the events with 2020 hindsight. Yet at the time, you didn't realize you were on the wrong path and walked right into the trap. Don't beat yourself up when this happens. Learning the hard way at times and paying the penalty of foolish choices and mistakes is a normal part of the life journey. In fact, this is what the universe calls the fool's tax. It's the price of acting without thinking, trusting without following intuition, ignoring inner wisdom, allowing the ego to pull you into something that, on a deep level, you know better than to pursue. The fool's tax is essentially the price you pay for your own mistakes. The greatest being not listening to your intuition and following your inner guidance. Stop and reflect on what you're doing right now, and check in with your intuition. Are you listening to its guidance, or are you drifting off track? Are you honoring your higher self? Or are you being coerced by your ego? You can reverse the course and avoid the fool's tax if you start listening to your intuition. One way or another, you'll eventually trust your intuition every time and avoid these unpleasant costs altogether. So again, the fool's wisdom is you live and you learn. So connecting the dots and going back to our conversation about surrendering and trusting the process. What I really took out of this was the fact that there are consequences and a price to be paid for not listening to our inner guidance. When you don't trust your intuition and give in to your ego, that's when things go wrong. Surrendering is releasing the ego and trusting your intuition. Trusting the part of you that is connected to universal consciousness. Trusting the process that this inner part of you already knows. Today's message. I hope that you are feeling very relaxed by now. Take some deep breaths with me. Breathe into the belly and exhale. Breathe into the belly and exhale. Breathe in and exhale. Yourself to digest all this information and energy. In a moment, I'm going to count down from 10 to 1 and leave you to sleep. Until then, you can just make yourself comfortable. Take some more deep breaths. Resting your awareness in your heart, feeling grounded in your body. Begin to prepare 10 to 1. With each number, your body is going to feel heavier and heavier until you drift off into deep, deep, deep sleep. Four, three, two, one, drifting off into deep. Tomorrow, when you awake, you're going to feel completely rejuvenated, well rested, heart centered, grounded, and consciously aware. You're also going to feel a lot more calm and relaxed, finding it easier to surrender into trusting the process. I hope you have a wonderful sleep. Hope you have
Thank you.